Hi guys, welcome to our channel. In this video we'll discuss about interlocking bricks and introduction about interlocking bricks, mechanism, sizes and prices, also advantages and disadvantages, finally conclusions. It is very important topic for your project, as well as these blocks are new building technology and gaining popularity these days, so don't miss the video, watch till the end. Let me introduce myself. My name is Vinay, and if you are visiting my channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also, click the bell icon. Let's start our video. Introduction. With the increase in the material cost in the construction industry, there is a need to find more cost-saving alternatives. So as to maintain the cost of constructing houses at prices affordable to clients, we need to find best material at cheapest prices and high quality. Next, the interlocking blocks are different from conventional bricks since they do not require mortar to be laid during the brick laying work. These interlocking bricks doesn't require any mortar to be filled with the gaps. Because of this characteristic, the process of building walls is faster and requires less skilled labor as the blocks are laid dry and lock into place. Okay, next we'll talk about mechanism. Interlocking bricks are enhanced from the conventional bricks. Each brick is constructively designed so as to lock itself to the other bricks without use of mortar. The self-locking is achieved using shear key and lock mechanism. Based on the design, shape of the shear key will be varied, and the complementary lock is provided on the opposite side of the block. Here the total load of the bricks is transferred by the shear transfer and gravity. Next we'll talk about type of blocks. Based on the material, we have mud or earth blocks, cement blocks, fly ash blocks, etc. Based on the mechanism, we have two types of blocks. You can see in the pictures. These type of blocks have two holes on the surface of the block, which are used to insert the rods or the reinforcement into it. And we can directly construct the house without the help of columns. The other type of blocks is lock mechanism, means these blocks are placed without help of any reinforcement. If you have any doubt about these two mechanisms or any specific doubts, you can comment below, or if you request us to make a separate video on this, we will try to make a separate video. And next we have sizes and rates. Interlocking bricks come in various sizes and locking systems depending on the supplier. A typical brick size is 230 mm by 100 mm by 75 mm, and the cost of interlocking bricks vary from 30 rupees to 150 rupees. Advantages of interlocking bricks. These are earthquake resistant because due to this locking mechanism, load is equally distributed among the walls, and these does not require plastering work as the outer surface is smooth. These provides cooler interior, and unskilled or fewer labors are required for constructing, and minimizes the cost because we save plastering work, labor cost, etc. And this is a time efficient work, as we can construct a single story building in one day. Disadvantages of interlocking bricks. If rainwater flows through these bricks, the color of the brick changes very fast, and it is difficult to ensure availability of same colored bricks for the entire construction. If the painting is not planned, all the bricks should be having the same color. For this, all the bricks have to be made from the soil at the same place, so it is very difficult and not suitable for buildings having more than two floors. If you are constructing without pillars, you cannot construct more than two floors. Conclusions. The materials required for block production and building construction are usually locally available in the most of the regions. Compared with conventional masonry, the dry assembly of interlocking bricks saves construction time and large amount of mortar. Additional cost reduction is achieved by building load-bearing walls since there is no timber formwork required for constructing. So from this video, you will be able to answer some of the few questions as what is interlocking bricks and what is the mechanism, types of interlocking bricks, sizes and rates, also advantages and disadvantages. If you want us to make a separate video on how interlocking bricks manufactured, you can comment below or message me on Instagram Civilogy. We will make a separate video on manufacturing of interlocking blocks. So if you like our video, please give a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also click the bell icon. See you in the next video. Thank you.